हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल सी थ्री डायमेंशनल स्केलिंग. सो एज वी हैव सीन सो फार द ट्रांसलेशन, 3D ट्रांसलेशन, देन वी हैव सीन 3D रोटेशन अबाउट थ्री डिफरेंट एक्सिस, देन 3D रोटेशन अबाउट एन एक्सिस विच इज पैरेलल टू वन ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेट एक्सिस, एंड देन 3D रोटेशन अबाउट एन एक्सिस विच इज नॉट पैरेलल टू वन ऑफ द कोऑर्डिनेट एक्सिस. सो दीज cases we have seen so far. Now we will see scaling, and in scaling we will be seeing two cases, that is normal scaling with the scaling factors, and then scaling about a given reference point. So let's get started. As you can see over here, okay, three dimensional scaling is carried out in this particular manner. Let's say I have an object, okay, this say tetrahedron shape I have, okay. So I want to scale the object. Okay, this is a three-dimensional space, so x, y, z. Okay, in three-dimensional space, and I have three different scaling factors. Okay, with respect to x, with respect to y, with respect to z. So I have this sx, sy, sz. Okay, sx, sy, sz, where the values of the scaling factors, okay, can be same or it can be different. Okay, it can be different. So I will write somewhere here. Okay, the these are scaling factors. Okay, with respect to x, y, and z axis. Okay, so I just extend the two dimensional scaling matrix, okay, to a three dimensional scaling matrix by adding a third row and third column, and the transformation matrix for three dimensional scaling is sx 0 0 0 0 sy 0 0 0 0 sz 0 0 0 0 1. Okay, so let's say I want to scale this object, okay, with given scaling factors. We will say the scaling factors are same. So what will happen? The object will be multiplied. Okay, object will be multiplied. So if I have same scaling factors, I call it as uniform scaling. If I have different scaling factors, I call it as non-uniform scaling. When the scaling is carried out with scaling factors greater than 1, the object tends to move away from the origin, as you can see over here. And when the scaling is carried out with scaling factors less than 1, okay, then the object is moved closer to the origin. Okay, so that part remains the same. Okay, and this is the transformed coordinates of your object. Okay, this is the scaling matrix, okay, scaling transformation matrix, and this is the object coordinate. Okay, object coordinate. So if we are just scaling a point, okay, this is xyz1. Okay, multiplied by the scaling factor is equal to the transformed coordinates for that particular point. If we are going to scale any object matrix or object, then I will have here object matrix with each vertex having xyz. Okay, each vertex having its coordinates in terms of xyz. So this is the first case. Okay, this is the first case. And then the second case is scaling with respect to a fixed point. Scaling about a fixed point, this is my second case. So now what happens in scaling about a fixed point? Okay, let's say we want to scale about this particular point xf, yf, zf. Okay, this same object that we have considered over here. Okay, so now what we will be doing, we will be taking this point back to the origin, because remember the scaling happens by default with respect to origin. Okay, by default with respect to origin. So if we want to scale with respect to some other reference point, then we'll have to take that reference point towards origin first. So that is called as the back translation. So translate the fixed point to the origin. So we call it as back translation. Okay. So here you can see the object was translated to the origin. Then we applied the scaling factor. Okay. Then we applied the scaling factor. So scale the object relative to the coordinate origin using above equation. So the equation that we will be using is same. This equation. So the scaling matrix we will be using. And then once it is scaled, then we will be translating the fixed point back to its original position. So it is going to be the forward translation. Okay, it is going to be the forward translation. So as far as this particular point is concerned, okay, I will have the transformed coordinates. Okay, transformed coordinates for the scaling are given like, okay, I will start from the object matrix on the extreme right. Okay. Then I will have translation that is also the inverse translation. Okay, the back translation. Then I will have the scaling matrix. And then I will have the forward translation. I will have the forward translation. So if I have to write them into the matrix form. Okay, I can write it very easily. 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0. We will take these coordinates. Okay, so we will take xf, yf, zf, 1. Okay, these are my translation coordinates. Then I have my scaling matrix that is S6 0 0 0 0 SY 0 0 0 0 SZ 0 0 0 0 1. And then I will have the back translation matrix, so that is 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 0, and I will be translating it in the negative direction so that the point becomes origin. Okay, the point becomes origin multiplied by the object matrix. Okay, multiplied by the object matrix. So this is what the transformed coordinates of my object. Okay, transformed coordinates of my object. So as far as the steps are concerned, okay, this is my step one. Okay, this is the scaling matrix that I have applied. So this is my step two, and this is the translating the fixed point back to the original position. This is my step three. Remember the steps that we follow. Okay, we start pre-multiplying the steps, okay, to the object matrix, okay, by keeping the object matrix towards the extreme right position. Okay, so I hope this three-dimensional scaling is understood. Okay, now what we will do is we will solve the problems on rotation as well as 3D rotation as well as 3D scaling. Okay, for your references. Okay, so we will solve this problem. Okay, which says rotate this cube ABCDEFGH, okay, with the given coordinates, okay, about a line P1 P2. This is the line coordinates are given. By 30 degrees. Okay, so we have to carry out 3D rotation about an axis which is not parallel to one of the coordinate axes. So the object matrix is given by this. This is going to be a 4x8 object matrix because the cube is having 8 vertex. Okay, so it is 5501, 10501, 10101. 5 10 0 1 5 5 minus 5 1 10 5 minus 5 1 10 10 minus phi 1 and phi 10 minus phi 1. Okay, remember I have gone with the given way of representing the cube. So it is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and I have kept it in that sequence only. So it is all the time, as you can see, the vertex is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Okay, so I will be maintaining this sequence while I need to do multiplication later. Okay, so I just come here. Okay, the first and foremost thing that is required is to find the direction cosines. So as you can see, direction cosines will be find for this axis, that is P1, P2 line, based on the coordinates of P1, P2. So I will be finding A, B, C respectively, that is x2 minus x1 divided by mod of v, y2 minus y1 divided by mod of v, and z2 minus z1 divided by mod of v. Okay, remember this mod of v is basically the difference, the distance square formula. Okay, distance square formula. So as you can see over here, 5 divided by under root 99, 7 divided by under root 99, and minus 5 divided by under root 99. So it is basically 5 square plus 7 square plus 5 square. So it is 25 plus 25, 50 plus 49, that is 99. So that is why in the denominator you have under root 99. Okay, then we also find this one more constant term, that is d, which is under root b square plus c square, which eventually comes out to be under root 99 divided by 74. Okay, under root 99 divided by 74. Okay, then we will continue further. Okay, we will continue further finding the remaining things. I guess this term is not under root 99 divided by 74. It is 74 divided by 19. Under root 74 divided by under root 19. Yeah, that is correct. So then we will continue further finding the sine alpha, that is b by d, so it comes out to be 0.8138. cos alpha is c by d, so it comes out to be minus of 0.5813. sine beta, similarly, which we require for y rotation, which is a, which is given by 0.5026, and cos of beta is given by d, which is 0.8646. okay, 0.8646. now we have to carry out this long multiplication. So this is the object matrix. So if you remember stepwise, okay, if you remember stepwise, so starting from the object matrix, we start pre-multiplying the object matrix, okay, in sequence. So we have a 5-step procedure. So this is my step 1, okay. I combine these two, this is my step 2, okay. Then this is my step 3, okay. I combine these two matrix multiplication, this is my step 4. And this is my step 5. So what we do basically, we translate this particular point to the origin first. So that is the back translation matrix I have written over here. Okay, so this, so I am translating this point P1 by minus 15 minus 5 minus 5. So that is 1 0 0 minus 15 0 1 0 minus 5 0 0 1 minus 5 0 0 0 1. Okay, then I do x rotation. So I rotate this particular axis about x. Okay, about x. So to rotate that axis about x, I require a reference. Okay, so that is why I project it onto the yz plane and find the reference. Okay, and then find these angles. Okay, direction cosines, that is sine alpha cos alpha, and using that I rotate it by this angle alpha. So it's a two-step process. So I first require x rotation of its projection vector, okay, so that the so that this particular P1 P2 falls on the xz plane, and then I require a y rotation with angle beta, okay. So so that this p1 p2 aligns itself with z axis. Okay, aligns itself with z axis. So it is given by the x rotation with angle alpha is given by 1000 minus of 0.5813 minus of 0.81380 0.8138 and then minus 0.5813 00001. Similarly, the y rotation is given by 0.86460 minus of 0.50260 0100 0.50260 0.86460 0001. Okay, then comes the actual rotation with theta. Okay, that is theta is given as 30 degrees, so we need to rotate that cube with respect to that line, okay, by 30 degrees. So it's a normal z rotation with rotation angle as 30 in counterclockwise direction. So the matrix is 0.866 minus 0.500 0.586600. So it is cos theta minus sin theta cos theta. Okay, here it was 100, it was cos alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha. Okay, then here it was cos beta, okay, minus sin beta cos beta. Okay, cos beta minus sin beta cos beta. And then you can multiply the remaining matrices, okay, by taking the angle as negative. So then in sequence we can further continue the matrix multiplication with we then rotate the axis, axis by minus beta angle so that it again comes back to the xz plane. Okay, then we rotate it with minus alpha angle so that it again comes in a three-dimensional space, and then we translate that point back to the its original location. So when we carry out multiplication, okay, for all these matrices, see these seven matrices are of the order 4x4. So what you can do, you can multiply these two, then multiply these two, then multiply these two, then you can continue further multiplication, and eventually you can multiply these two. Okay, the order that you are gonna get, you will get four new matrices. Okay, then again you can multiply the answers of these two. Okay, you can multiply the answers of these two, and then you can multiply the answers, and then further you can multiply these two answers. Okay, and eventually you will have to multiply the answers, the two matrices that you will get. Okay, and eventually you will get this as the final answer, which is again the order 4x8. Okay, again the order 4x8 and representing the 8 vertex, okay, with a fraction number, that is 9.464, 15.562, minus 0.701, 11.436, 11.022, minus of 0.095, 12.929, 15.672, 0.911, 10.956, 20.214, 0.306, 7.874, 17.043, minus of 5.192, 9.847, 12.502, minus of 4.585, 11.34, 17.153, minus of 3.578, and the last, that is the F coordinate, it is 9.367, 21.694, minus of 4.184. The entire last row is of ones because it's a homogeneous coordinates representation. So I hope this problem has been understood. You can say slightly lengthy calculations, okay, but nevertheless, if you are able to use an advanced calculator, you will be able to do this calculation. And you can also, what you can do is you can write a program, okay, you can write a program where you will accept the coordinates, okay, you will accept the coordinates of the object from the user, and then using a program you can find all these values, okay, all these values very quickly. And you can also find the reference about which the rotation needs to be carried out, and then you can find out all these values and carry out these multiplications very quickly using a computer program. You can do program in C graphics, or you can do program in Python. Okay, the idea over here was to explain the procedure. We have already learned the how these seven matrices have arrived. Okay, now this was an attempt to showcase how the actual problem can be solved using the procedure that we have just learned. And I have taken a cube or cuboid because it's a three-dimensional object. Okay, and I will have eight vertices, so the only major multiplication I require is at here, where I am multiplying 4 by 4 and 4 by 8. Even that is possible manually. It may take slightly longer time, okay, but still it is possible manually. Okay, and you can always write a program to do these multiplications very quickly. So I hope this is understood. Okay, I'll meet you next time with more such problems. After this we will see the scaling problem. Okay, after this we will see a scaling problem, and then we will stop. Okay. Okay, so then we will continue with the scaling problem. So this is a three-dimensional scaling problem. As you can see, okay, I have given here a tetrahedron, okay, with the square base, and not tetrahedron, but it's basically a pyramid with square base, and then it has a apex, that is the corner, the top corner, and the dimensions are provided. Okay, and it needs to be scaled non-uniformly with different scaling factors. For SX it is 5 units, for SY it is 6 units, SZ it is 7.5 units. And the scaling needs to be carried out about a point which is the apex point, that is E15, 20, 0. Okay, 15, 20, 0. First thing that we do all the time is write the object matrix. So object matrix is following the sequence A, B, C, D, E. So it is A, B, C, D, E. It's 10, 10, 0, 1, 15, 10, 5, 1, 20, 10, 0, 1, 15, 10, -5, 1, and 15, 20, 0, 1. Now what we have to do, we'll have to first bring this point E back to the origin. Okay, bring this point E back to the origin. So I will carry out the back translation. So here I have written the transformation matrix for back translation with the transformation or translation coordinates as -15, -20, 0, okay, because z coordinate of E point is 0. Okay, then I will carry out the scaling. So this is a scaling matrix with SX 0, 0, 0, 0, SY 0, 0, 0, 0, SZ 0, and 0, 0, 0, 1. And then finally I will again translate the reference point back to its original position. So this is a forward translation. So this is a forward translation. So, and on the extreme right hand side I have my object matrix. Okay, extreme right hand side I have my object matrix, so I can perform the multiplications. Okay, the orders are, object matrix is of the order 4 by 5, and remaining all the transformation matrices are of the order 4 by 4. So I can carry out these two multiplication and find the answer. Then I have multiplied these two, found the answer, and at the last I multiplied these two with the order 4 by 4 and 4 by 5, and I got the final transformation matrix or the transformed coordinates for that pyramid as -10, -40, 0, 1, 15, -40, 37.5, 1, 40, -40, 0, 1, then 15, -40, -37.5, 1, 15, 20, 0, 1. Okay, so the thing to look here is, since we kept point E fixed, or the scaling was carried out, non-uniform scaling was carried out about point E. Okay, as you can see in the final answer, point E remains unchanged. ok point E remains unchanged. So that is the thing to cross verify. So I hope the problems are understood well. Okay, we have seen the rotation problem and now we have seen the 3D scaling problem. So I hope the content was understood. Okay, stay tuned for more such content on computer graphics as well as computer design. Okay, thank you very much.